You know, the Jewish nation, the Torah said that they have three stamps. Three stamps. Just like when you convert a non-Jew, three rabbis sign on his conversion certificate after they saw that he went into the mikveh. Three dayanim sign on a certificate. The Jewish nation also have three signatures on them. One, they are merciful. If you see a cruel person, it cannot be Jewish. Cannot be. What do you mean? I mean, we saw that he was born to an Israeli girl. His mother is Jewish. No. Her grandmother is probably Mizera Amalek. Jews got mixed in Europe non-stop with the non-Jews. Non-stop. Lithuania, Russia, Hungary, France, England, any country, Czechoslovakia, Austria, Germany. Jews married the Goyim for 230 years. There's no way to know. Unless it's European Jews that are religious non-stop, son of a father, of a father, of a father, all ultra-Orthodox, then you don't have to worry about their Jewish identity. Anyone that is not Jewish already for few generations, I mean, is not religious for few generations, there is a higher chance that he's a non-Jew than a Jew. Almost all Reform Americans are Goyim. Biologically, they're not Jewish. Same thing in Europe. You see, when you meet a Syrian Jew, you don't have a reason to suspect that he's not Jewish. Nobody there married a Goyim, not one out of 1,000 even. If you meet a Yemenite Jew, don't have to worry at all. Not one Yemeni was ever Mechalel Shabbat. If you meet an Indian Jew, there's a higher chance he's a Goy than a Jew. You may not even know it. Why? The Jews got mixed with the nations there in India. So they have statistics. They know in each country what percentage of intermarriage the people had. The best place is Yemen. Over there, nobody got mixed with the Muslim Yemenites. Nobody. But in some countries, it was very big assimilation. Like Germany, almost 80% before the Holocaust. So there's no way to know. So if you see someone that tell you I'm a Jew and you see that he's a cruel person, most likely he's not Jewish. And what's the second sign? They have shame. They shy. Bayshanim, they're not arrogant. They should not have that chutzpah. So, Bayshanim, Rachmanim, Vegomle Chasadim. And they're kind, generous. See, who's the number one in donations in the world? Jewish people. Unfortunately, 99% of them donate to the wrong causes.